We talk about it. We've identified it. We've talked about it. But also the non-conference. We went and played a ton of really good teams that on paper probably should have beaten us, right? And some we won, some we lost. But just putting them in the situations where everyone's going to bring their best, or they're bigger, stronger, more talented, right, in some way, shape, or form. So really just putting them in situations where we still have that underdog mentality, whether we think we're going to win or not, or people think we're going to win or not. So I feel like it's been the conversation, but also kind of how we've set up this non-conference.
Going up against UNH, obviously a team that you guys know very well, what are some things that you remember about them? And just looking at film, what are some things that are maybe a little bit different this year?
They just play so hard. They're tough. They have fun playing basketball. They've been down bodies in the past. They're pretty close to full strength right now. So I think that you can't take them lightly. It didn't matter if they had 5 players stressed or 15. They just play so hard. They really do have a lot of everything right now. They have scorers. They have some really nice post play. But at the end of the day, I think it's a team that you can never take lightly. They're just so tough.
After the Princeton game, you talked about how you thought that your team was a little timid and that they didn't shoot the ball with enough confidence. How have you added that over the last week or so?
Watching film and showing them, you know, some of the conversation with our players is more not like, it's not so much about them. When you identify something and say, this hurts the team, that they take more than to shoot the ball. So sending the message where they understand they really do care about each other. So watching film, talking about it, and in practice, forcing the issue a little bit. Like, okay, what just happened? What happened when you didn't take that shot? So really just identifying it, talking it through, and challenging them. We need it, right? We need you. We need you to step up and hit a shot in these situations. So also drills, a lot of drills, seeing the ball go in always gives extra confidence. So trying to really finish with a lot of drills in practice when they're tired and seeing the numbers. So doing different things, but reminding them they're really talented players. And it's tough when they don't believe in themselves when everybody else around them believes in them. So trying to remind them of why they're here and what they do well and what we need from them.
That Princeton game was the third straight game you've given up at least 60 points. What are you looking for defensively now that conference play and those games that really matter getting underway?
Yeah, it felt like our defense had been really strong from the beginning, and then our offense finally started to pick up, and then our defense is slack. So we got to figure out both sides of the ball consistently. But, you know, taking away tendencies has traditionally been something our players have done really well, and I felt like the last couple of games, while they were very talented, we still didn't do what we can do to take them a little bit out of their rhythm. So we got back to talking about that, really watching film and breaking it down and making sure, like, it's straight to the point. This is what we got to take away. We're challenging them. I think they understand that in conference, there's really good players, and we're going to have to make them take tough shots. And we saw what happens when we don't, right? So sometimes the loss, there's more to learn from that than just a loss.